a dolly has injured itself doing ordinary stuff. What a terrible travesty when simply living life has become so dangerous that you get injured. Hello, everybody. Great Steel Blaze, and I'm here with a new game for the channel called The Universim. No time for BS. So the Universim is a very large-scale management style of game. It's considered a god simulator or a planet management simulator style of game. The idea is that you get a planet, and you're going to help that planet kind of build and flourish and research in a sandbox style of game. The planets are procedurally generated, and there's just, it's very, very artistic, very cool. I kind of got to show it to you. We're in alpha version, bunch of numbers, cheesecake. Taking a line after Android or something like that. Maybe it'll always be food. It's going to make me hungry now. I can't even eat cheesecake. That is not on the diet, people. Let's go on here with Start a New Life. We're going to do this right away. Now, I have had a lot of fun with management-style games. I'm a big fan of things like RimWorld, which I've done a lot of gameplay for. Things like, even stuff like Taito Ecology, which is more like an ecological management style of game, not so much like a colony manager like RimWorld. So this is even bigger than that. We're gonna manage the whole damn planet and not kill everything, hopefully. But there's a lot of kind of stuff to this game. There's a little bit of a tutorial. I think I'm gonna go ahead and push past most of it. The game is very intuitive for the most part. It's an interesting mix of being kind of complex enough to have fun, but simple enough so that you can just get in and get things going. So right here it just says, welcome creators. Now remember, this game is very alpha, I just want to let you guys know that, and it is not out on Steam yet. So you're not going to be able to play it, there is a demo. I'm going to leave some links in the description below to kind of get you to where the game is and where some information about the game is. There's a Kickstarter page, there's also a Twitter account where the folks making the game here are going to post updates and the like. Feel free to kind of follow them and find out what the direction of the game is. I'm very, very excited for this game. Anyway, it just says that thank you for dedicating your time and effort toward improving the Universim throughout its development. The game is progressing well, but it's still buggy and in unfinished state. These early releases are in no way representative of the final game, and their primary purpose is to test functionality and systems as they're integrated into the main game. So, that's what we're going to be doing. Doing a little bit of testing here. Would you like to play the tutorials? You can skip them at any time if you want. We're going to go ahead and not do the tutorials right now. So I'll give you guys kind of a little indicator of how the game works. So there's a couple of ways that you can manage, well, not manage, but I should say kind of look around your planet here. Very, very easy though. We can use the WASD keys. That kind of gives you like a nice smooth little movement. We can right click and drag, and that allows us to go all over the place. And if we hold down the space bar and then we WASD, we can just like zoom in. You see how it's almost like we're flying, like we're on a plane or something like that? And what's really cool, let me pull back again. What's really cool is you look at this place and, you know, here it is, man. This is our planet. It's so cool. And then you think to yourself, oh, you know, it doesn't really look that big. But when you get down here, you can go into all the little, you know, biologies and things going on here. Look at this. We got some, what is this, saguaro cactuses right over here. Some deciduous trees, some evergreen trees. We got different biomes. Are those pumpkins or something? I don't know. Some sort of melon or something over there. We got the winter biome over here. Let's check out all our biomes, man. Now, remember, these are procedurally generated. We can use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out very quickly. Over here looks like almost like an oasis. Kind of plains-ish. Oh, and there's weather effects and all kinds of stuff. Look at this. We got a lightning storm going through our world here. But yeah, this is our planet, man. And we're going to get to manage the thing as we see fit. So now I thought I saw, oh, look at this. We got big old rocks and mountains over here. We got some rocky crags on this side. So what I'm looking for and what we kind of want, Look at all the storms around here. Oh, and there's a day and night sequence. And as you move, look, there's a sun that circles the planet. I love this so much. This art style is so cool. I'm fangirling too much about the art style. We should be playing the game. But I wanted to show you guys this because I think that this style of play and the amount of detail that they put in here with the stars kind of fluttering about and the fact that there's a dynamic day and night. And as you move around the planet, the temperature, the storms, there's some shooting stars there. The storms and the weather and the time changes is just very cool. So to build, we're going to want something very temperate. We're going to want a, you know, near a body of water, and we're going to want some stones and some trees as well, obviously, because we're going to need all that for our materials. Looks like there's some stones and trees here. Looks like we've got a couple of plants on the ground there. We've got a nice forest over here. Oh, this is actually an excellent area. Wow. This is a real, look at this. We got some blueberry bushes. We got a ton of stone over here. And we are near a big old body of water, a nice lake over here that we can probably fish from. So I think this is where we're going to go. We'll kind of zoom out real quick and just take another little pass around our planet. Look at that rocky crag area. You know, we don't have a lot of water on our planet, I'm noticing. What is this over here? Oh, it's like stony, look at this. It's like stony formations over here in the desert. That's kind of cool too. All right. Well, I think I like this area the most. The other cool thing is that we're also right next to the desert. The desert can be pretty damn useful, man, because in the desert, you can kind of grow things year-round. So, let's go ahead and this is our very starting building here. This is our kind of our little town center, if you will. We can use the Q and E keys to rotate it around at our will. So let's go ahead and, where do I want to put this? Let's put it right, probably just right in the middle of all this. It's pretty near some trees. It's near some stone. Yeah, let's put it right near all these bushes over here as well. That should do pretty damn good. And we've got just a ton of rocky crag stone areas over there. I'm going to put it right, boom. Confirm your location, confirmation, yes indeed. So there we go. Welcome to the Universim. Our very starting area has been made, and now we're gonna get little guys here called Nuggets. Yes, Nuggets. So, pretty warm area here. There's seasons in the game as well. You can see it's 28 degrees Celsius where we are right now. This is our civilization's age. We can only play right now in the Stone Age. So that's as far as we're allowed to go. And we do have, you can see it's coming into night here, so it's gonna be getting dark pretty soon. But some of the things that we're gonna wanna start off with right away is we're gonna wanna start getting like water and food sources and everything for our guys. You can see they're already getting food over here. We got some berries, local temperature, like I said, 28 degrees Celsius. We can click on everyone to kinda see a little bit about them. Citizen of Mother Planet, that's the name of our planet. I don't know if we could change this yet. I wonder, can we? I don't think we can yet. Says right here, though, you can see there's a bunch of stats. So Xyla doesn't have any kids yet. She doesn't have a spouse or anything. All this stuff will change as she goes through the game. You can see here things like her, kind of hover over this, this is the health, and then it shows each interval what happens for each of these items. So interval one, the nugget's health is either full or will slowly recover automatically over time. Number two, it is slipped into too low and recover automatically, but their movement speed will be slowed. And then three, the nugget is in critical condition. God, the name Nuggets. I love that. That's so cute. So, they've already started getting some wood. They've already started getting some stone. So let's start and get some things done. We're going to need water. We're going to need food. Over here, this is like your construction tab, and this is the resource area. Pretty, like I said, this is very intuitive if you've ever played any kind of management style game. So over here, we can build, well, we can see that we could potentially build different things. Look, we have all these different factories and refineries. We don't have any of those open yet. We've got farms, which we're definitely going to want, like, big time. So we're going to want to put that down. We also have a fishing pier, which we're going to want down. That's going to be a great way to get some food. You can see your civilization has figured out that they can consume most other life forms without too many deadly repercussions. This thought process has now led them to the water's edge, where they have discovered what will one day become known as fishing. Let's hope they don't sink. Let's hope they don't stink up the whole village. Well, I love seafood, so damn it, we're going to be doing this. So right about here is where I'm hoping we'll be able to put our little fishing pier. Let's go ahead and start on this. Yep, right there. You can see, if I move it over here, we can't put it down. And then if you get close enough, boom, clicks right to where you're allowed to have it. Fishing pier it is. We have plenty of resources to get this started. If you click on it, it'll show you kind of who you have potentially to assign as constructors. But the game is very, very, like I said, intuitive. It will put these guys on here by itself if it wants to. So, but you know what? I'm going to go ahead and prioritize this. I want this area to really get started in its building. So we'll kind of prioritize this. Now, I don't know if you can, like, click and drag. Oh, okay, looks like you can kind of see where everyone is. That's fine. So let's go ahead and get out of here. There we go. They are all starting to work on our fishing village. Summer has come. It is 31 degrees Celsius, so it's pretty hot in the area I chose. But that shouldn't be too bad. I think they'll be all right. Yeah, they'll be fine. We got, like I said, we got the water's edge right over here as well. Where's the cooler temperatures, I wonder? If we go over here into these rocks, look at this rock formation. It's so cool. What happens if I go through this? Can I go through this? Oh, you can. You can kind of clip right through it. Very interesting. But it's good to be in a little bit hotter area because we're going to have to deal with winter eventually as well. You know, it's not going to be all sunshine and roses all the time, man. So not only do we have our construction panel, we have this right over here, which tells us everything about our planet. So our planet has 7 mammoths, 103 black bears, 261 rabbits. Holy crap, look at how many hawks are on this freaking planet. Jesus. And 10 humpback whales. We go over to resources. We don't get to see any of those yet, unfortunately. So there's a lot of coming soons here. Oh, and there's something else that you need to know. We have things called god powers right over here. These god powers, I think if I hover over it, there we go. The creator powers menu. You can use these. You can use the middle mouse button as well. Inside, you will find a full list of godly powers at your disposal. Oh, all the powers of the cosmos, baby. They're in our hands. To reward or punish, the choice is yours. Inconceivable! Ever wondered how you lose 100 or so kilograms of useless fat? Cut them out of the relationship! Oh, burn! Okay, so obviously the game has a little bit of ha-ha to it. This power will make a female nugget pregnant without the help of a mate. We've got all kinds of cool stuff. Construction influence, all kinds of things. We're going to deal with that in a little bit. I do want to get some more stuff started. Like I said, we do have the fishing village underway, but we're going to want water for sure, so that everyone has something to drink. So let's go back into our building area over here. We've got that farm, remember? But over here we have a water reservoir and a water pump. We are going to want a water pump big time. So let's get that started. There is our little place right over here. So let's go ahead and get the water pump a-going. Go ahead and put the water pump right over here, right next to our fishing pier. Ah, the fishing pier is fully operational. So now that we have a fishing pier, we can't just leave it here. We should probably assign someone to learn how to be a fisherman. So right over here, the fish population is 15,052. So we have plenty of fish in the sea. Let's go ahead and assign someone. Now, everyone's just kind of generic. No one really has, like, a ton of skills or anything like that. Like I said, you can get a quick idea of everyone's abilities. And everyone's strength is kind of average. Everyone's pretty happy for the most part. They are getting kind of thirsty, so it's good that we're going to start getting water. Although there's a lot of rainstorms in this area, so that's kind of nice. Oh, being in a hotter area as well, our guys and girls are going to need water a lot faster than if we weren't in this. So there you have it. Let's give these poor bastards some a way to fish though. So we're gonna go ahead and give Elu. You sound capable. You, sir, are gonna be the new fisherman going to the fishing hut. Elu is now a fisherman. Congratulations, Elu. Ma'am, I think ma'am. Pretty sure you're a ma'am. Yes, you are. You are now a master fisherman. Oh, she's married to Adahi. And they have 2 kids. Man, people are already having kids. This is the fertility ring over here. When this gets full, well, you know what time it is. It's fun time in the city. How's our pump doing? If we click over here, we can see 86. Okay, so it is getting there. It's getting around. Now, we're going to need a well once our water pump gets done. So let's go ahead and start that as well. Kind of redundant, but whatever. Where is yonder well at? Water reservoir. We don't quite need that yet. I just want a well. Forecast tower. That's so that we can find out what the, what our weather's gonna be like. So that's kind of cool. Oh, we have a bunch of buildings over here. We're gonna want to get all this stuff. Look at this eatery. It's kind of like the tavern, man. Place where you can sit down, eat and drink, and I don't know, receive quests or something if this was medieval times. So right over here, the well. I'm going to put the well in the center of town. This is, again, this is like our little town hall. So we're going to want this pretty close to that, I would reckon. We'll put it... Oh, this is a house, by the way. They'll start building their own little housing structures. Where's our... Oh, okay, we're going to put it on this side. Here we go. We'll put it, like, right over... Now, if you want, don't put it on top of resources like the stone. This way they won't have to sit around and clean it out themselves. So we'll put it right here. Now they can mine that stone at their leisure. They don't have to clean it out in order for us to get anything built. Oh, God. Here we go. So thirsty. I would prefer water from a well rather than a lake. So thirsty. Where's that well? So everyone wants that well. You can see right now they're probably just drinking out of the lake, but no one's happy with that, man. People want a well. People want a well big time. So right now everyone's over here with their pickaxes at the ready. Look at this. Right here. Pickaxes at the ready. We've got fantastic wardrobe selections, including the hot pink leopard skin or whatever that is. This poor guy over here, is this person naked? Not really sure. I don't know. Everyone's getting very thirsty though. So if we don't want everyone to die, they're going to have to get started right away. Resources required. We need 5 more wood. And they do have plenty of wood laying around. So hopefully they can go and get that. If we ever want to speed things up, we can utilize the plus key, by the way. And then this little button over here is to help us see our people at night. It gives us, like, god night vision. Let's see what we can do with our creative powers. Maybe there's something that we have that can help everyone out here. Basic object interaction. This is the bread and butter of any god who doesn't love throwing stones, trees, or people around. The harder you're flinging an object, the more damage it will do to anything it hits. I don't know if I want to throw people around quite yet. What are these down here? We don't have any of these yet. They're coming soon. Oh my god, meteor strikes, tornadoes, volcanoes, lightning strikes. You may be asking yourself, why would you want to do anything like this to these poor people? Well, you never know. I mean, maybe you have too many people in the world and you've got to cull the population, huh? How about that? Plant a tree. Okay, so this is a lot of cool stuff here. Plant a tree. Plant 10 trees. Plant a stone. We could create stone, baby. Create a cloud formation. That's kind of cool, too. So, construction influence. They're not really programmed to do as you wish, especially when it comes to construction. This is why you need a way in which to communicate your orders without drawing too much suspicion. Casting the focus power on a building will cause it to shine brightly and draw construction nuggets to the scene. Okay, so, if we want stuff to get done ASAP, this is what we were going to need. So, I'm probably going to go ahead and do that. We're not really using our creative powers for anything else, so let's go ahead and do that. Creation influence. Put it right over here. How's that? Right there. It doesn't really look any different, per se. I don't know. Did I end up clicking on the, let me try it one more time. Hold on. Oh, we need 120 creation points to do this. I think all we have right now is 60. I'm pretty sure. Cost of the currently selected power. Okay. All right. Well, yeah, all right. Yeah, so this is our creative power points. We have like 23. So we're gonna need many, many more. Guys, get on this if you don't want to die from dehydration. I'm sure you're all not feeling too fantastic about how things are going on here. In fact, let's go ahead and take a look at our people if we can. We can go over here to the, oh, we can't do it that way. I guess we could just click on individuals if we wanted to. So it looks like if we select on everyone, we can kind of see how they're doing right here. Go ahead and select on Xyla. Xyla is very, very thirsty. So a lot of them are pretty thirsty. Some of them are just going to drink from the lake. But again, that is not their preferred method of drinking. How's our water pump thing doing over here? So it's at full capacity right now. It just needs a well to start moving that water in. All the wells receiving final touches. There we go. So right now the well is being fed water. And you can see right here it's going to start filling up. And it can keep so many people well-watered, well-hydrated. That's probably the way to put it. So we're going to let that go. 22 degrees Celsius right now. Temperature's pretty darn cool outside. In fact, I think it got a lot cooler than it was. We got some clouds moving overhead. Pretty damn sweet. So we got some fish over here. We got our well starting to go. We can probably do a reservoir eventually, but we don't really need to do it yet. Right here, you can see. The water pump was full before, but now that we're starting to feed water into the well, it's got to start doing its thing. How's the fishing progress coming along here? What was your name? Who did I put over there? Elu! That's who it is. Citizen of Mother Planet. Looks like she's doing pretty good. Look, she's heading out in her canoe. Ooh, can we see fish in here if we look real close? Hold on. I'm looking around to see if I can, like, see fish. Kind of wonder what she does. Let's watch her for a little bit here. Kind of doing the fist pump gesture. That's how you fish over here in the Universim. I imagine she's casting in her line and this is her reeling it in. Oh, I wonder what that was. It looked like a dandelion. That's pretty sweet. I love the environments for this. Oh, she is getting fish inside of the boat. Look right there. I think that's our fish, man. Yes. The fish are plentiful on this day. Looking good, looking good. Oh, we got some lovemaking going on, baby. Mm-mm-mm. Wow, holy cow. things are really going on in here. Xyla and Labaha are getting down to business, and they are getting down to business, like, big time. So, Labaha and Xyla have returned to work. Albeit a little untidy. Oh, a new nugget by the name of Lambu have arrived. They're a little too small to do anything, most likely. So they're going to have to grow up to be big, strong individuals. Over here, look at this over here. We've got like a, almost looks like a hunting skin going down. That's kind of cool. How's our well doing? Well's pretty good. People should be getting something to drink fairly easily. So now that we're done with the water area and such, let's go ahead and build a farm. So out here in the desert, I wonder how much the weather changes. 23 degrees Celsius right over here. Wow. So 23 degrees, 22, 21. Look at the drop. Look, if you hover, you have to put your cursor on the land and it will kind of show you how things go. So 16 degrees Celsius, 17 degrees Celsius out in the water. And then out here in the mountains, wow, things drop down big time. Oh, cool. Look at this. The water hits the screen. That's so cool. All right, man. Very cool. Local temperature, 13 degrees Celsius. So it gets cooler when the water kind of comes down here. So if we wanted it to be a little bit warmer, we could make the farm out here. And I very well may. I may make the farm like right over here because the farm doesn't really care about the soil composition so much as it does about the temperature. So if you wanted to, you could build your farm like way out here in the middle of the desert so that in the winter you wouldn't have to deal with like those cool weathers. So let's kind of see here. What do I want to do? I would like to kind of keep my farm close to the area though. Let's see, what's our temperatures like over on this side of the world? 13 degrees Celsius, 13 degrees Celsius. So it stays very, very temperate. And then it starts to go up a little bit as we go near the desert on this side. So right over here, it's a couple degrees hotter. So let's make our farm out here. You know what? What the hell? We're going to put our farm a little bit more out into the desert. That's what we'll do. 16 degrees Celsius right over here. Yeah, let's do this. Farm right out here. Boom. That's what we're going to do. So you can see the farm is a decent sized critter. What way do I want it? Let's put it kind of facing directly at our main hut. So we're going to put it right there. Boom. Farm is down. That's going to get started now. Let's start making some of the other things that we have too. Like, our guys are going to want to be happy, right? So I imagine they're going to want that eatery. Just a little place to kind of congregate and stuff. Let's get that down. I would want a tavern if it was me, man. Have a cold brewski. I imagine we haven't really... Oh, more lovemaking going on. I imagine we haven't really... Well, didn't they say beer was one of like the earliest created items when it comes to drink or alcohol in general? Let's see here. Ilu and Adalbihi look rather pleased. I wonder what they were up to. And Nambambo has just been born. Okay, they have no idea what they were getting into. Nambambo may be the best name of anything I have ever heard of in my life. So this eatery, let's put this, like I said, in an area where there's not many resources right now. Let's put this right about, I want to keep it again, pretty close to our town center. With a nice, you know what, let's give it a nice lakeside view. Yeah, nice lakeside view. Let's put it kind of right over here. They can see the lake right there. And they're going to be able to take a cool look at these mountains where they can have awesome adventures. This kind of looks like an area, man, where you would go in and mess up some monsters or something. It does look really cool. I kind of like our selected area. Oh, look how cold it is at the top of the mountains. Negative 8 degrees Celsius. And then when you go down on the floor here, 5 degrees Celsius. So much, much cooler here. We are in the fall right now. You can see by the classic Canadian maple leaf how the fall is going on. So how's everything going right now? Down here we can see what we're producing water-wise. We're producing 8 units of water, and we're only using 2. So we have plenty of water to keep everything going. If we click on here, you can see our water. We now have 3 water units on here. So that's doing fantastic. We can click on our people over here and kind of see what they're doing. They're building this farm out here. How you doing? Happiness. 70. Although I don't think happiness is in the game yet. I think if you hold over it right now, you don't get to see. Yeah, it's not even in the game. So, she's well watered. She's still a child, I guess it says, sort of? Oh, they're an adult and they're ready to work. So interval one, she's just barely in interval two. She's 18 years old or 18 units old. I don't know what you consider that. But her occupation is mate. That is very, very controversial. Her occupation is mate. Well, I hope she's good at it. So our girl over here that goes out into the waterways, what is your occupation? Her occupation is eat. Maybe this means that, like, she's good at helping people so that they can eat. This place is awesome. I don't want to leave it. That's what they think of Mother Planet. So we're doing well, guys. All right, man. The crafting is still going on here. I think I'm going to wait until... Oh, the farm is able to stand up on its own. So now we have our farm over here. Kind of nice, too, because, again, look at how much cooler it is over here by our town center. 3 degrees Celsius over there. 9 degrees Celsius over here. So now we can select things to do. So let's look at what we can... Well, let's get everything built. I think we have to till the land before we can plant stuff. But the overall temperature, 7 degrees Celsius in this. That's like the generic temperature, so kind of sweet. So we got that going. Oh, I think we're going to have to get some farmers in here as well. So let's get some farmers going on, man. Oh, here we go. Fishermen. Occupation fishermen. Said eat, drinking, mating, waiting for lover. Aren't we all? So who do we want here to be a farmer? Lambu, you look like you could be a potential farmer. You are now a farmer, and let's do one more. What? One more farmer. We're gonna do Adahi. Oh, right here, Adahi. You can be a farmer as well. I don't think we should have any more farmers because we're gonna need some people to just like be able to build this and stuff. Because we still have this eatery that needs to go up. Oh, we got plenty of god points, man. Maybe we can start doing things. Let's see here. Construction influence. Yeah. There we go. Okay, so that does work. You saw right there. Our points went down, and there was a little glowing area around this. So I'm just kind of telling everyone, hey, guys, when you're done getting the sex on, they've concluded their nap. Man, babies get born really fast in the Universim. Holy cow. No time for that laborious process. We get the workforce up big time around here. Ooh, how are our crops going? Getting built. Okay. So, yeah, go ahead and build those crops, girls and boys. Come on, start your tilling. I'm just kind of over here looking to see how it looks. Seeing if they're... Oh, preparing plot. Here we go. Going to farm. Preparing plot. Yep, go ahead and do that. We got no units of food right now. So I'm just waiting for them to do our thing. You can see here, this building uses 2.5 units of water. So that's good that we've got some water being harvested, I guess, from the water. Or from the water area. There we go. Now the plots are getting built. Sweet. So they're going to go ahead and do that. Back over on this. Oh, look. Winter's come, guys. And this is kind of why it was important. Look at this. -4 degrees Celsius. And this is an excellent opportunity to kind of get in, to kind of see what our temperatures are going to be out here. So right about here, we were at -4 over where we were. Now it's about 2. So it stays just barely above freezing over here on this plot. And that's going to be pretty good. Because that's going to allow us to maybe have a better crop than normal. All the snow is gone. No more time for snow, man. All the snow's gone, man. We got our people working on the eatery over here, which I'm very, very happy about. How's the lake looking? Oh. Hold on. Did the lake freeze? Oh, look at this. The lake started to freeze over. You can actually watch it. Oh, that's so cool. Because out here, it's still unfrozen. But the closer you go... To the shoreline, the more frozen it is. Oh, look at the fish over here. She's butchering the fish. I'm really happy that they went ahead and kind of like put the effort in for all these little animations. I think that kind of stuff is really what makes games like this interesting. When you get to see everything that everyone gets to do. How's our crops doing over here? 97%. We can start choosing a crop. What do we got? Minimum of juicy acorn over here. Juicy acorn. Excellent all-arounders. They're able to grow quickly and optimally in a large temperature range while also outputting a reasonable amount of food. So we get, I'm guessing this is like a 4 food stuff yield. I don't know. It's good in 0 degree weather, but it's good in 50 degree weather as well. Mambro fruit. Listen here, bros and broettes. This fruit is perfectly comfortable in its masculinity, but that won't stop it from flexing at every passerby. It's pretty fast, so its growth rate. And so is its growth rate. It doesn't yield much, but at least it seems to handle temperature change as well. Over here we have crystalline crayon apple. A fruit that shatters like a fragile gem in the mouth, melting into a delicious and nutritious liquid. That's like Gushers! Someone must have decided that a shiny rock looked good enough to eat. And they were right! Fruit yields the highest food output, but also takes the longest to grow. So it's good in 0 and 50, so pretty much like the juicy acorn. And then the bloody diarrhea fruit? What? The bloody diarrhea? Who made this? A name that only an unfortunate nugget could conceive. And fortunately, its toxins can be neutralized through a relatively simple process, but its name remains an honor to its founder. Its output, it outputs very little food, but it's such a pest that it grows in almost any climate. What? Outputs very little food. Looks like it outputs like 8. It looks pretty good, doesn't it? It takes as much time to grow as the juicy acorn. I don't know, maybe you want a lower time. Like, let's see here. Pretty fast, the growth rate is fast, but it doesn't output very much. I don't know. And then the panda brain plum, the most resilient crop of them all. These plums can handle the extreme temperatures on either end of the thermometer, but their yield is very low considering how long they take to grow. Eating panda brains is an absolutely a last resort. Oh my god. Okay, we're not eating panda brains. That's freaking horrible. Let's go ahead and do, I don't know, man. Probably the juicy acorn would be good. I hate to say it, but the freaking bloody diarrhea fruit would be good too. Isn't that terrible? What's our temperature over here? 5 degrees Celsius right around. So this area remains right around 5 degrees Celsius. Not too bad. I don't know. Let's go ahead and, the crystalline crayon apple. You know what? Let's do, this sounds really cool. Let's make a crop of crystalline crayon apple. All right, I'm gonna do it. We'll make a bloody diarrhea fruit. Jesus. I feel so weird doing this. It sounds horrible. The planting queue. You can select up to 2 crops to place in the queue by clicking on the plus icon. You can swap out or completely remove crops from the queue by clicking on them again. Your farmers will plant the new crops in the order you selected. Okay, cool. So we can really make things very specific on how we build it. Let's go back over here to our eatery. How's things going on at the eatery? Oh, we need a cook. All right. What do we got here cook-wise? Nanmambo. You, sir. You are now a cook at 10 years old. Oh, the child labor laws. Where have they gone? Can we get 2 cooks in here? Yeah, I guess we can. Gathering. Idle. No time to be idle, Elu. Time for you to learn how to go cook for the clan. All right, man. We've got 8 people so far. Things are looking pretty good. And let's see what else we can make real quick. Okay, so we've got our eatery, we've got our well, we've got a constructor's hut, a cemetery, and a hospital. Nuggets will inevitably come down with some other ailment, which means they'll be missing valuable work hours. A witch doctor will get them back on their feet in no time. It's probably best that you avoid looking into their treatment methods. That sounds fantastic. We need a hospital. I want a hospital big time. So let's go ahead and put that... Where do I want this hospital at? I think I'm going to put this kind of right over here. Yeah, right over here should be good. Again, I'm not going to try and block any of our little resource areas. We're going to put this right here, close to the village. Want to keep it fairly close to the village. We'll start building outward. I'm going to... That kind of direction that it was in is pretty sweet, too. I think we just moved into fall, guys. Current season, right? Oh, spring. I'm sorry, spring. And if you look here, you can see all the little different icons for each one. We have our 4 traditional seasons. So right now, baby, hospital's underway, getting built over there. Oh, hold on. I think that the eatery is starting to get underway here, too, of use. Yes, we got our cauldron. They're cooking up a storm over here, 98%, 100%. Yes, sweet. So things are looking good with our haunch of meat. That's the way this place will be remembered for all time. Very cool game, though, so far. Man, I'm loving this. This is really neat. I mean, we got our farm flourishing over here. We got babies being born all over the place. You know how it is. We've got the crystalline crayon apple and the bloody diarrhea fruit getting ready. Shambomhu has reached adulthood, so now they, too, can enter the slave labor. And we got to flex a little bit of our god powers. We haven't done anything at all, though, yet. There's still plenty left to do. We have to get our hospital up, after all. I think I definitely want to come back to this one. This is a really cool-looking game, guys. I hope that you enjoyed some of the gameplay of it, though. Let me know if you did. Oh, God, right here. a dolly has injured itself doing ordinary stuff. What a terrible travesty when simply living life has become so dangerous that you get injured. Is this what it's like to just fall down the stairs or something? It's a good thing we're getting the freaking hospital done, man. Not a moment too soon. Anyway, guys, feel free to let me know in the comment section below if you want to see more of this game. I think this is one of my favorites so far. Until the next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.